हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल इंडस्ट्रियल एजुकेशन। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एनालिटिकल बैलेंस। टुडेज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ बैलेंस, इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ बैलेंस एंड ऑपरेशन ऑफ बैलेंस। फर्स्ट बैलेंस इन्वेंशन हिस्ट्री इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम मोस्ट एशियन रेलिक ऑफ द वेइंग स्केल हैज बीन डिस्कवर्ड इन इंडस रिवर वैली डेट बैक टू अराउंड 2000 बिफोर क्राइस्ट। नाउ वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ बैलेंस used in pharmaceutical industry. The pharmaceutical industry use a wide range of weighing instrument. This can be categorized as load cell, platform scale, precision balance, analytical balance, semi-micro balance and micro balance. Let's we discuss about the capacity of balance. Load cell. Load cell have capacity of 10 kg to several ton. Platform scale. Platform scale have capacity to 1000 kg or more. Next is analytical balance. Analytical balance have a capacity of 500 gram. Next is semi-micro balance. Semi-micro balance have capacity of 30 gram. And last one is micro balance. Micro balance having normally capacity of less than 1 gram. Next we are discussing about the importance of balance. Weighing on the analytical balance. Weighing is the frequently step in an analytical procedure and the balance is an essential piece of laboratory equipment in the most of analysis. In spite of this, the weighing is a common source of error that can be difficult to detect in the final analytical drift is one of the most common error and it is also one of the result. As per US FDA guideline, the weighing procedure is separated in three basic steps: planning, checking the balance and weighing the material. Let's we discuss about the calibration. How to calibrate an analytical balance. Analytical balance calibration is important if we want to accurate reading of material being weighed every time. Let's we discuss about the step-by-step procedure of calibration. First is the internal calibration. It must be performed as per the manufacturer instruction. After warm-up, next press the key for auto calibrate. The internal calibration will first display no weight measurement. After that, it will require specified standard weight to place on them. Next one is the external calibration. It is done for the three factor. First one is the drift. Normally a 10 mg standard weight is used for carefully out drift check and you have to be recorded measurement with a 10 mg weight in a observed variation in a result. The second one is measurement uncertainty. Place 10 mg external weight on the balance pan and note 10 measurement for the weight. Next, carry out the required calculation for determination of measurement uncertainty by multiplying the standard deviation by 3 and dividing the actual mass value and the measurement of uncertainty not exist 0.001. Third type of external calibration is performance check. Place 1 mg, 2 mg, 5 mg, 10 mg and 20 mg calibration standard weight separately on the top pan. After the auto calibration process, note the measurement in a performance check log and the measurement should remain within 0.1% of the actual mass value of each weight. After calibration, we are discussing about how does an analytical balance work. Analytical scale measure the force needed to counter the mass of a sample rather than using actual masses. They use an electromagnet to generate a force to counter the sample output, the result by measuring the force needed to achieve balance. Let's we discuss about the uniformity of dosage unit. The term uniformity of dosage unit is defined as the degree of uniformity in the amount of drug substance among dosage unit. The uniformity of dosage unit can be demonstrated by either two methods, that is content uniformity or weight variation. First test is the content uniformity. The test for content uniformity is based on the assay of individual content of drug substance in a number of individual dosage units to determine whether the individual content is within the limit set. Content uniformity test requirement as per IP active less than 10 mg or 10%, as per BP active less than 2 mg or 2%, or as per USP active less than 25 mg or 25% for average weight. The second important test is the weight variation test. The weight variation test performed for the 20 tablet randomly selected an individual weight compared with the average weight of the tablet. लेट्स वी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेट वेरिएशन लिमिट एज पर आई पी बी पी एंड यू एस पी थ्री टाइप ऑफ द लिमिट इज डिफाइंड 10% 7.5% एंड 5% ऑफ द स्टैंडर्ड एवरेज वेट। थैंक यू दोस्तों फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। अगर आपको हमारा वीडियो पसंद आया है तो इसे लाइक शेयर एंड कमेंट एंड सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूले। जय हिंद जय भारत।